Welcome to the NX for Manufacturing Tech Tips. Today's tech tip will address how to use NC work packages on the shop floor. With that, I'll turn it over to Corson.
Good morning or good day, everyone. Glad to be here and present the capabilities or give you an introduction into Shop Floor Connect for Teamcenter. And I just wanted to do, as a start-up, as Derek said, the last time there was Dave Madeley presenting how to create work packages and store it into Teamcenter. And I just wanted to recap on this. What is a work package before we are going to use or are going to show you how we're going to transfer this from Teamcenter down to the shop floor. So as we can see on this slide here, a work package basically is a container which holds a lot of information which you may have already today stored in the PLM system, or you have stored in either a folder on your in your hard disk or wherever. So obviously, what we have seen a couple of weeks ago, that was how to store this data, the manufacturing data around a work package, into Teamcenter as a database system. So on the next slide, so basically you can see that is the contents of the ANSI program, or let's say the CAM file will be stored or is stored in a database and for further usage. So before we can download the data to the shop floor, so means to the ANSI machine, so in that case we would need to go along and basically store the content in the PLM system. So we cannot store that content in a folder structure on your hard drive. So we would store that to be managed in the PLM environment. So what gets stored? So that could be all sort of content. So it can be obviously the setup information. So what are the tools that have been required or used? What is the ANSI program that we have outputted? What will be eventually data that needs to be captured in a manufacturing sequence, such as a milling operation on the machine center, and what will be any standards or documents that needs to be available for work instructions. Obviously, such as the work instructions itself, could be a drawing, could be a shop documentation that has been created from NXCAM. So that is basically a package or a container of information that we want to download later or make store in the database and make available to download it to an ANSI machine. So on this slide here, what you can see is basically, or what we have seen last within the last presentation, is how the ANSI programmer and how manufacturing engineers are storing their data in the database, in Teamcenter as the backbone system. This week we are going to see how a shop floor user is going to access the data from the shop floor without having the necessity of knowing, how Teamcenter works, how, database application is working at all. It's just about to see what is the data that is available, and obviously to see what is the most current and most the data that has been created most recently, or what is the data that has been released for me in the manufacturing environment. So therefore we have an application called Shop Floor Connect for Teamcenter, which basically is a DNC add-on to Teamcenter. So it's not a separate database. It is fully an add-on package or an add-on module to Teamcenter. So all the user data, so user logon, all the authentication information is handled in Teamcenter. We can access workflows from Teamcenter. We can use workflows that are being created in Teamcenter in order to trigger actions within your shop floor environment as well. And we can also basically control whatever a user can download data or can upload data back to the database. So, and you know, the most obvious user to use the DNC system is the ANSI operator at the machine tool. But since we have visualization capabilities within this environment, any shop floor user, such as a shop floor manager or a tool manager or a tool setup person or quality inspector, could use this interface as well in order to access the data which is stored in Teamcenter, or even push data back into the database from here. But depending on the type of user we are facing, so we will also present different type of user interface. As seen a couple of weeks ago, so there is we have integration of Teamcenter in the NX environment. So an ANSI programmer has a view, as you can see here, on the data that is stored in the database. So he can visualize a work package. He can basically open it from NX. He can view the attached ANSI programs to it, and he can also see all the resources that have been used within this work package. Versus a manufacturing engineer that is working with teams within the Teamcenter environment, he will have a slightly different view, but accessing exactly the same data but within the Teamcenter portal view. So he sees the resources that are attached to this work package, so let's say the fixtures, the tools, the machine tool obviously, but also the ANSI programs and the list of tools here in the right-hand side. Versus the shop floor user, he is maybe not a skilled person, you know, that works within a trained environment where he has got some training on how to use the database environment or how to use a CAM system. So to him, we want to present a very straightforward web-based user interface he can access from basically any device that has a web browser on it. So this could be obviously a computer, it can be a machine controller, or it can be, you know, your iPhone or your mobile device that has a web browser. So within this environment, you could go and visualize the data. So let me quickly give you an overview on what we are basically addressing in a manufacturing shop floor environment. So as we have seen, we have different people in the manufacturing engineering environment which will author the data into the shop floor. So it means they will go and create ANSI programs, they will create tool lists, they will create fixture lists, maybe gauge lists, ANSI programs, any documents that is work instructions. They will store manufacturing time, and all this information is stored, as we have seen in the illustration before, against this work package. Now depending what role you have in the company, you would have a different view, as I said before, to the data. So once this data is stored in the database, then obviously that will be the moment a work order can be released. Now it can be done when you're using an MES system, which we have in our portfolio as well, but obviously it could be also done just by giving a work order or a traveler down to the shop floor. So then the operator or the shop floor operator or user is using the shop floor connect user interface in order to download the data he wants or he needs to download to the machine tool. So with this, we are with this shop floor connect user interface. We're gonna see in a bit while I'm demonstrating it later. You can download the ANSI program directly to the machine tool, and obviously with this, all the resources will be also downloaded and spread it to the different department. So, for instance, if you have a tool management system in place, so obviously the tool list will be extracted as well out of this work package, and then we would have the tool setter starting his job and doing the communication with the machine tool, retrieve the tool list out of the machine tool, and basically preset and set up or assemble the tool he needs to assemble and send this information finally down to the machine tool as well. While in our demonstration today, we will be focusing on the DNC functionality of Shop Floor Connect. So this should give you a view on how we are basically accessing the data from the shop floor and how we can download the data to the machine tool. And obviously, maybe during the night shift, you want to do some modification to the ANSI program on the machine tool itself and upload whatever you have changed as an operator, if you have the capabilities or if you have access rights to do so. So let me switch over and basically give you the presentation here. And just sharing my screen here and now giving you first maybe view on the data as we have stored it in Teamcenter. So that will be the manufacturing engineer view on the data from within Teamcenter. As you can see, we have here our work package, which is the 460 work package, and it contains a lot of information. So it has maybe some PDF file attached to it. It has some ANSI programs attached to it. It has shop floor. It has shop doc attached to it in order to give some work instructions to the operator as well. We can see here there's a little yellow bubble on our icon on this ANSI program. When we visualize it here within the internal viewer, we will see the content of the ANSI program within Teamcenter. So, but as I said, that is the view on the manufacturing engineer, which is trained on how to use Teamcenter and which will create the whole manufacturing process in this environment. As you can see here, we have a little little yellow dot, which means that this ANSI program and visualizing on the right-hand side has some status attached to it. So that means we have release status, or we have statuses that we are controlling if the people in the shop floor are able to download the programs or if they're not allowed to download the ANSI programs, depending on the status we have. Now let me switch to the operator view, so to the shop floor operator view, which would use Shop Floor Connect in order to access the data. So first of all, he will get on this web UI, he'll type in his username. I'm just a regular DNC user right now, and I'm logging in to the database. And first of all, I'll get presented the, or we'll get a view on the whole workplaces that I have. So that will be my machine shop, or my my cell I'm working on, or my environment I'm working on. So we can obviously have different views on that. So we can say, okay, me as being Corsin, the shop floor operator, I'm working with three machine tools. So in that case, when I'm logging in with my login, I will see only the three machine tools I'm working with. But in that case here, I have a view on all the different machine tools. And now I want to work on the DMC 125, which I want to download data from. And as we have seen before, we have the first menu will show us that I can get data. So I'll download data basically, or I can upload data back from the machine tool back to the database. Or I can also create new programs. So for instance, I've created a program on my machine tool, and I want to store it back into the database in order to have a managed NC program. I don't want to leave it on my controller or on an external drive or whatever. I want to manage it within Team Center. So that is the place I would, or the option I would use in order to create the program in Team Center. So, but first of all, we will get the data. So, and therefore, I'm going to go for get data. And as you can see here, we can have an online keyboard. So we can, if your screen is touch panel enabled, so we could type it directly on screen. And obviously, if you have a device like an iPad or an Android tablet, so you could directly type it on your keyboard on your mobile device. But in that case here, I'll just type in the number, and as we have seen before on the screen, so we could either get this information from an MES system, what is the item ID or the work package ID I need to download. Or if we would have a barcode scanner on our workstation, then obviously we can connect to a barcode scanner and scan the work package ID in here as well. In my case, I just type it in, and as you can see here, we can use wildcard search as well. So I'll just using wildcard and search for this data package in Teamcenter. So what is done now is basically we're connecting to the database, we're extracting the data out of Teamcenter, and we present exactly what is available in there. So that means in this case here, these buttons here on the left-hand side are configured dynamically. So if there is an NC program attached to the work package, so this button will appear. If there is no NC program attached to the work package, so the button will just not appear. That's it. So it is configured dynamically. In the middle of the screen, so you're going to see here that is the generic information of this work package. So it is it has item ID, the name of it, who is the owner of it, so it's Mike Manufacturing, the last modifying, and when it has been modified lastly. So we can put more information on here, so that's all the information we can display here, which is available from within Teamcenter. So let me, let's browse through these different buttons to see what is attached and important for me as a shop floor operator. So first of all, there is an NC program attached to it, and I can see because the status is set, as you remember in the Teamcenter interface, we had this yellow button on it, or a point on it. So the status is set to DMC check. So that means I'm allowed to download the program to the machine tool, and therefore the transfer to a machine tool will be allowed here. But before I'm doing so, I can go and say I want to view it. So let me view the NC program before I download it. So therefore, I just go for the visualization button, and the ANSI program will be listed, and I can go and, you know, visualize or view the ANSI program and what the content of it. And obviously, I can go then and say I want to transfer the ANSI program. I can go and start transfer here and just transfer the data from Teamcenter to the machine tool. And now it has been sent to the machine tool. We'll see where it is, it has arrived just in a while from now. But there are also some drawings attached to it, or some images attached to it. So for instance, I have some tool images or tool graphics that has been attached and extracted out of the database. And I can see here on the right hand side as well, so transfer is not allowed. So obviously, it doesn't really make sense to send images to the machine tool, and therefore the transfer will not be allowed, but I can visualize it. So we can view the data, and I will have a JPEG image of one of the tools I'm working with. On the next top button, I have PDF documents to it. So PDF document would be, for instance, here a setup drawing. So I can view the PDF file as well, and there I have a setup drawing, such as a work instruction for me as an operator, can see how this part has been placed on the machine tool. And maybe there could be also some dimension and obviously some markups as well within this drawing. So that's nothing else as viewing the drawing that is attached to this work package. But there is also a 3D model here. So let me go and have a view on this 3D model. Obviously here as well, I cannot visualize the 3D, I cannot transfer the 3D model to the machine tool, but I can view it. So let me view it, and I can go and just open it, and it will open my viewer, my 3D viewer, and I can visualize within here in this environment, I can view this 3D model on my screen directly. And obviously, depending on what viewer you have in order to visualize the 3D data, what capabilities you have, you could go and measure, get some information out of the model, how long it is, and you know, create a section view on it, and basically visualize this 3D data for you as being the operator. And last but not least, there is a shop document attached to it. So we do have an operation list that gives me some information about the operations, what type of operations has been created. So we have a very small program, but three operations, like a face milling, a pocketing, and a slot milling, have been created. And we have also different views on it, so we can go and visualize all these data as well. Okay. So now, obviously, because physically I do not have a machine tool here, as we have seen before, I just transferred this program to a virtual machine, which basically is just a shared drive on let me log in here on my server. So let me access this here. It'll take a second to log into the server. And I want to show you, so this ANSI program, so it's 5:29 now my time here in Europe. So it has been transferred at 5:25 p.m. and that's the ANSI program that has been downloaded basically the machine tool. Now assuming we want to do some modification on the machine tool itself. So in that case, we could go here and say, I'll just copy this file here and say 1, 2, 3, 4 and call it optimized. So that would be my optimized ANSI program. And here I'm just gonna open this in my editor and basically, you know, add some text in here. This is shop floor modified ANSI program, and add some comment here, and I store that here in the database. Now assuming you do that on the machine tool, right, so you will go and you will do some modification because you're working on the night shift. There is no ANSI programmer around that could fix your issue or your problem. So we could go back and say, I want to go back to my entry screen and say, I want to upload data now because I did some modification and I want to pick an ANSI program, which obviously is now my optimized ANSI program, and I want to attach that to my 460 work package. So I'll add it in here, and I say I want to add it as a new optimized to check ANSI program, and I'm gonna submit it and upload it back to the database. So the upload has been created successfully, and it has been now entered from the shop floor, from the machine into the database. So going back here to the main menu, I can have a look on this and just double check if I, as an operator on the machine tool, would see that this has been updated correctly or has been uploaded correctly. So I'll just go here and I go for the ANSI program, and I can see immediately so that this ANSI program, the optimized, has been uploaded to Teamcenter already. And if we view that, so then we will see here, this is a shop floor modified ANSI program. So it has been created in the database. And obviously when I go back here in my Teamcenter in environment, and I would go as an ANSI programmer, and I will come back here, I would also see that this here has, that we have created, I'll just refresh that. Okay, let me. Give it a second. Okay, so probably I just got a timeout here from the database. So my, just let me log in again because I have a timeout. So I just minimize the screen here and let me log in again so we can visualize that in the Teamcenter database. So there we are, so 460, and we can see here how we have now an optimized ANSI program that has been created in the database, and you see that we have, because it is an uploaded ANSI program, we have a different icon, so we can immediately see, okay, there has been an ANSI program sent back from the shop floor. As I said before, this can be configured. So if that is capable, if a shop floor operator is allowed to upload ANSI programs or not, so that is depending on your access rights and how you define it in your environment, in your Team Center environment. But that illustrates a little bit, or shows a little bit, so that you can basically send data back from, send data down from Team Center directly to a machine tool, and you can also send data back and upload data back to the database with full control here. Okay, so that would conclude the demonstration piece. So I'll just switch back here to the presentation. So what we have seen here is Team Center plays the single source of data. So that means I'm creating a work package in NXCAM, in Team Center, store the data against the database, and exactly the same data is being used on the machine tool. So I can search for the data from the web UI, from the shop floor connect for Team Center web UI. I can go visualize the data in this environment on a lightweight non-installation viewer, and then I can download the data. So we can ensure that there is no data duplication here. So there is no two times the same ANSI program in the database since it is managed by Team Center. We have a full traceability for the manufacturing data. Something which I haven't mentioned now is all the transfers. If I download the ANSI program or I upload the ANSI program, so we will have the logins for that, so we know exactly by what time the ANSI program has been downloaded last time or has been uploaded. So it is an easy to use web UI for the shop floor user. So it's just, we don't need training, we just need, you know, like a maybe a 15 minutes training how to use it. And the product data, production data, is stored in one system, and we only have one time definition for all the user group, all the access rights, so the permissions for the user. Archiving and management of shop floor programs are possible as well. So that means when I want to create an ANSI program on the machine tool, I want to push it back, so that is possible with Shop Floor Connect as well. So again, Shop Floor Connect for Team Center is not a separate DNC server, it's just part of Team Center. So with that, I'm concluding the presentation, and I think we open up for questions.
Great, thank you, Corson. I think we see how these work packages are used and executed on the shop floor. And as always, the conversation will continue at our discussion forum. We'll post whatever questions come up and their answers, and we can pursue any follow-up topics at that time.